Well, we have a Fender Telecaster from the U.S. of A. Spanky color. I like it. I don't know if the camera's even getting how cool that red looks. Anyway, somebody screwed up the nut and they cut the slots all too deep and it's got first fret open string. We don't like that. We hate that. That one's even worse. Right? So that's got to happen, but why waste our time if that doesn't work? So back to my golden rule. Does the truss rod work? So we'll just see what we got before we get all excited. And right now the neck is like, wow, way too straight. So when I get in there, I'm going to want to relax that a lot. Oh yeah, it's going to go crunch. Wait for it. Well, maybe not. It's just really tight. Someone's cranked the shit out of it. Let's try something like that. Well, I let it go too much. But maybe that's not the problem, right? Let's just turn that back about that much. Now that we've got the neck curve right, let's also check the string height, because that everything affects the nut. And if the other stuff isn't right, don't go carving at the nut. Don't ever start there. That looks good there. Oh, my old magnifier. Soon I'm just going to glue this to a hat. Just wear it all the time. Get two of them. Right now the string action is way too high, way too high, way too high, way too high. Well, it's all consistently way too high, so maybe the guy liked it like that. Okay. But let's put a measuring stick on that. The middle ground for that measurement would be 20 thousandths of an inch. And right now, it's way too low. I wonder what it actually is. Let's try. It's like 13 thou. So we are going to bang that nut out of there and get this straightened out. Okay, we're going to smash that out of there and replace it with this. I very, very seldom cut a nut from scratch anymore. Unless it's like some sort of obtuse guitar. And I'll tell you another story. Well, it's not a story, it's the truth. Right? Okay, so Tusk. This is that whatever synthetic self-lubricating synthetic material that whatever it is. But if you want a pre-slotted bone nut, Hosco make them and solo guitars sell them. Isn't that amazing? Isn't that cool? Just give that a little rappy tap there. Don't hit too hard. Blow the back out of the slot. Just try and loosen it up a little bit like that. And then I'll get my get you guys in a movie. I just hope this thing cooperates and we don't end up with a mess like that other one I had to saw it out. Oh, there we go. Can I pluck it out? No, I gotta keep hitting. Come on now. There we go. And it's the curved bottom, so I gotta take the little niblet off the bottom of the tusk, and we'll just gently run a file in there to clean off the old glue. So I'm actually not even using the file, but it's the right width. So I'm actually just using a little corner of the file, and I'm using it to scrape away the old glue. Because if I use the file's flat, and I'm going to disturb that curve, right? That's going to be great. Okay, so got some files out. Once again, this is sort of about the right width to knock that down without wrecking the curve. Go with the coarse one again. Oh, I slipped. No worries. Still got a ways to go. And go with the real fine guy. Finer guy. A little bit more. I quit. So now we must get the width correct, and this is very, very close. Like, so close, it's going to take four scrapes. Dave's guesstimate. So what I do is I get this really sticky tape. Right? You can use whatever tape you want, but this is like this Gorilla tape. This thing is tough as sticky. And I make like a little handle. Sort of like that. Then I stick the nut to that piece of tape so I can hang on to it. And then the other side sticks to my fingers. And this is that super flat piece of, I think it's some sort of countertop synthetic marble, super flat surface anyway. So I said four scrapes. We did that many scrapes. And we'll peel it off of there. Try and get it off your fingers. Don't lose it. We might need it again. What happened? Oh, a few more scrapes. But I like to get it so tight that you really don't even need glue. Hey, look! Somebody likes me! What the hell? Usually there's a little bit of width adjustment, but not on this one. It's the perfect width. That's it. It's in. I can throw away my little tape thing. All right, give it a quick clean up, throw the strings on it, and before we glue anything in, or that, just have to adjust each slot individually because of the curved bottom. All right, so that's the beauty of a straight across flat nut slot, is that you can just take material off the bottom and slowly bring it where it needs to be. But not today. Yeah! So what's left now? It's cleaned up, string it up, and see what we have for string height up top here. Okay, so we're going to tune it up. We're going to do all the other adjustments, and then we're going to measure our first fret action and see what has to happen to each and every nut slot. So this really was a pain in my pain. The pickup, the neck pickup, way too close to the strings, way too close. And you actually see abrasions in the pickup where the pickup was actually hitting the string, and the string was hitting the pickup. So, no big deal. Hey, we're just going to pop the pick guard off, get this set to the right height, and put the pick guard back on. But oh no, no. Because of the fingerboard extension, you can't get this out of there. You got to take the neck off to get the pick guard off to adjust the pickup height. I'm not joking. I just go, why? Especially when, okay, here's the deal. I know why. Because they just used the pick guard that they have for the other guitars that doesn't have this. But you don't need all that plastic. It doesn't show. You could cut that away. And then you could take this off. And adjust the pickup height without having to take the neck off. Thank you very much. Anyway, I'm done at this end. Alright. We're going to carve the nut slots to the right depth. And go have a sandwich. It's a little sonic demonstration. I've already recut these two, the A and the E, right? So when I get the 20 thou feeler gauge in there and I sort of hit the string, right? But when we go to the one I haven't cut, right? So that's what I like to hear. Okay, four more to go. Now we gotta visit the other end again because this affects the string height a tiny bit. Okay, so I'm down to the last slot. Always double checking you're using the right side of the file. I hate the way these are marked. It's just frozen. I have to look. Sort of that. Oh, and always remembering to get all the dust out of the slot because it will affect the string height. That's sort of it, folks. Cut the strings and send it away. I don't know. What kind of sandwich is it going to be? Grilled cheese? Ham with lettuce? I don't know. Meatball sandwich. That sort of sounds interesting. For all you meatballs out there. Anyway, thanks for hanging out, folks. I gotta clean up some stuff here and fix something else. Imagine that. Things that break that can be fixed. You don't have to buy a new one. You don't have to throw it in the garbage and buy a new one. You can actually fix it. There's not much of that left on the planet. All the links to great things are right down here. Look below the video. Special shout out to my patrons. Thank you so much for being there for me. Everybody who's grabbed a sticker or a Penny Black CD. The Facebook group. Keep it rocking. Keep it clean. And Twitter people and everything. And everybody out there watching. Subscribers. Be good to each other. Cheers. Be safe.